All right, babe, I am back with a new video. So I get questions about this topic all the time. Do I need a modeling comp card? Do I need to make my own? Is the agency going to make one for me? And if I do need to make my own, what do I need to put on there? So this is what we're gonna talk about in this video. It is your girl, Kamla-Kay. I am a professional agency signed model and a modeling coach for aspiring models. Let's dive right in. So first and foremost, what are comp cards? Comp cards are these little bad boys right here. They are cards that basically have images that represent you as a model. There are some agencies who have comp cards of different sizing, but generally speaking, 5.5 inches by 8.5 inches, either horizontally or vertically, is what is typical within the modeling industry. Now, what is on a comp card? A comp card is basically your portfolio, a snippet of your portfolio. So as you can see, this is an old comp card of mine with an agency that I used to be signed within the Miami area. So the front of the card basically had a headshot. They went ahead and decided on a smiley commercial shot for myself. And then it has the agency name on this half. Now the back of the comp card has varying pictures of myself that shows a different image of myself, a different viewpoint of myself. So for instance, how the front had my natural curly hair, the back here has a photo of me with a straight wig, as you can see. And then in the middle is another photo of curly hair. And then here is a bikini shot. So basically what happens with the comp card is that the agency is trying to show you in different styling, in different types of looks, because there's gonna be some clients who wanna see you smiling, some clients that's gonna want to see you more serious, some clients that may wanna see what your hair looks like pulled back. So the agency's purpose of doing the comp card is that they can show a snippet of your portfolio and what looks you can give for the client. Agencies will use these to basically showcase you to a potential client. So let's say that an agency has signed you and they want to send you on a casting call. A casting call is basically a meeting with a potential client for a job. So that could be for a TV commercial, it could be for a print job, it could be for a runway show, things of that nature. So when you have a comp card, it basically allows the agency to give to the client something tangible that they could have to be able to keep on file of your portfolio. So if you go to a casting call, a lot of times clients will ask that you bring a comp card with you so that you can leave it with them, so that as they're flipping through everyone that they have seen for the day, they can flip through the comp cards and then be able to narrow down which models they want to use based on what they remember of seeing you in person, and then also their backup reminders of what you look like and the different kinds of looks that you have. It's really important on your comp card that you have a variety of looks. So for example, I have a headshot here, then I have a headshot but with different hair, and obviously some models, their hair looks the same all the time, right? It's just, as a black model, a lot of times clients want different looks. And I actually have another video where I really focus on, and I'll link that here somewhere, where I focus on the different types of wigs that a lot of times black models will have and that I personally use, because there are clients that want my hair curly, some that want it straight. So I'll link that here for you. So here I have a photo of me with my longer straight hair, and then I have curly hair. But you'll notice also in the middle one, I have shorts on. In this one, I have a bathing suit. It showcases more of my body, because there are gonna be clients that want a different look from you. They want maybe a professional look. They wanna see what you look like in more of a fashion sense, or maybe they wanna see what you look like more of like a J. Crew, Old Navy, Target kind of model. So it's really important that your comp card shows variety and that you don't have all pictures in the bathing suit or just all headshots or what have you. And based on if you're a commercial model versus a fashion model, commercial models tend to have portfolios or comp cards that have more of smiling faces, bubbly, it shows who you are and shows your personality. Whereas fashion models, on their comp cards, a lot of times they are serious in all of their shots. Maybe they'll have one shot of them smiling, but generally with fashion models for their comp cards, all of their images are of them being serious, looking stoic, like the traditional Vogue pictures that you see. Now, besides the actual variations and photos that you want to see on a comp card, what else should you have on there? Something that should always be on a comp card are your statistics. So you will see across here, the agency basically has my height, they have my shoe size, my hair color, my eye color, my dress size, and they also have my measurements. So it's always bust, waist, and hip measurements. When your measurements are on there, a lot of times, since there's clients that may come over from Europe to the United States or the United States and goes to Europe, what have you, a lot of times on comp cards, your statistics are written in inches and in centimeters. For instance, when you write your height, you want to make sure that it's written in inches and in centimeters. And sometimes even when you apply to modeling agencies on their website, you'll notice that they ask for your measurements, your height, your body measurements, for instance, in centimeters. Some will ask in inches. So just keep that in mind sometimes when you see statistics on a comp card. Now, another thing, agencies will generally make a comp card for you if you are signed to that agency. However, let's say that you are a freelance model, or even let's say that you are signed with a modeling agency and maybe for whatever reason they don't have a comp card for you. What I have done for myself, because once in a while, if you don't have a comp card for that agency but you need to meet with a client for whatever the reason and you don't have a comp card, or if you're a freelance model, you don't have an agency and you need to meet with a client or you need to submit your pictures for the potential consideration of a job that maybe you found online or that someone contacted you about, it's always nice to have a comp card regardless of the situation. So when I create my own comp card, I am really mindful of thinking first about the type of client, whether it's commercial or fashion, that I'm submitting to determine what kind of headshot I use. Now, also based on the client, generally speaking, a comp card will have 4 images on the back. However, when I created this comp card, my personal comp card for myself, there was a client that had specific projects in mind. So what I did, I went ahead and put multiple pictures on the back. And so let's see. Basically, it's an overview of me showing beauty shots, commercial shots, and fashion shots. And so you can just see quickly here. And so what I did, I wanted to give the client a variety because this was something that I was submitting to a personal client and this was not through the agency. So I always have my own comp cards that I make for myself just in case I run out of my agency comp cards, that I'll have something to leave with a client, because you always want to have a comp card that you can leave with a client just in the event that as you're leaving, they ask you, hey, did you bring a comp card? You want to be prepared. If for some reason the agency is not making one for you, definitely you want to make one for yourself or have someone make one for you. And actually, in my model coaching class that I teach to aspiring models, part of what I do in my class is I instruct models on the types of images to have on their comp cards, and I also will make the comp card for them as part of my service of them taking my model coaching class. So that's always something to consider as well. If you are totally lost and just even how to go about this process to begin with, feel free to contact me and we can go into that a little bit more detail if you want me to create a comp card for you. You also want to make sure that if you're creating a personal comp card for yourself, that on the bottom of the card that you have a way that clients can contact you. So you should have your email address, your phone number, and now that social media is such a big thing, if you have an Instagram page, you can go ahead and add your Instagram handle on that as well. Now, if it is a comp card that was created for you by a modeling agency, the agency will have their contact on there. So when you meet with a client through an agency, the agency will have their contact on your comp card, because a client will always need to contact the agency directly if they want to book you versus contacting you if the casting or booking was orchestrated first by the modeling agency. All right, those are all of my tips for the quick comp card overview, what they are, what's included on them. If you have any questions, comments, feel free to leave them below. Would love to hear from you. Also, definitely subscribe to this channel, thumbs up, share with anyone else that you think could use some tips on the modeling industry, and check out my blog if you have not done that as well, because there is so much more content on there. This YouTube channel is fairly new, or at least at the making of this video, it's fairly new. Now, until the next video, be sure to comment and let me know what kind of content you are looking for me to create next. And I'm so excited once again to have you on my channel. Super thankful for you. Until the next video, have an amazing week. Peace out.